Okay, good evening. My name is D.S. Barbole, lecturer in mechanical engineering from Government Polytechnic, Jintur. My topic is the continuity equation and the Bernoulli's equation. Okay, now let us go through this. Now we will have some questions. Okay, so how plane flies? Next question is how perfume spray? Okay, next one, how ball swings? Right now World Cup is going on, yes, Bumrah, Bhuvneshwar do the swing, yes. So how they swing this ball? So to know this answer for each and everything, we need to have a understanding of the Bernoulli's theorem. So at the end you should have a understanding of this equation, two equation, a continuity equation and another one is the Bernoulli's equation. Now, so whenever we say any equation, there comes some assumption. So assumptions are some prerequisites. So let us revise that. First one is the fluid should be a ideal. What is meaning of ideal fluid? Yes, ideal fluid means it should be frictionless. Okay, next, it should be a steady flow. So first thing, what is the flow and which thing flow? First thing is that fluid flows. Yes, what is the definition of fluid? Simple question. Definition of a fluid? Yes, the substance which occupies the shape of a container and which can flow, that is called as a fluid. Now, whenever it is, volume flow rate of this fluid is called as a flow. Okay. Now, so steady flow. What is the meaning of steady flow? Steady flow means with respect to time. Yes, there should not be any change in a velocity at that point, that is called as a steady flow. This is the one prerequisite. Okay. Next one, streamline flow. What is the meaning of streamline flow? Streamline flow means the particle which is flowing should not cross each other's path, it is called as a streamline flow. Next one is the incompressible flow. What is the meaning of incompressible flow? Incompressible flow means, yes, density should not change, that flow is called as a incompressible. Another thing is that we are here for this equation, these two equation, first one is the continuity and Bernoulli's. For these two equation we are excluding three things. Yes, thermal energy we are excluding, yes, by virtue of temperature, whatever the energy we are excluding. Then heat transfer, thermal energy, rate of thermal heat exchange we are excluding, and the shaft work. These three things are excluding. Now, again, now begin with the first point, continuity equation. What is this? This, it is the law of conservation of mass applied to the fluid flow. So, what is law of conservation of mass? Now, if I take any object or any pipe, yes, whatever the mass flow rate in should be equal to mass flow rate out. So, I can write here, I will write m1 and here m2. So, this is mass flow rate in is equal to mass flow rate out. So, now here continuity equation, what it says? It is in a confined system is there. Okay. Now, in a confined system, whatever the thing as a inlet should be at the outlet. So, this is the here mass flow rate. What is the definition of mass? So, density is including the mass definition. So, what is the definition of density? It is the nothing but the mass upon the volume. Okay. So, mass upon volume. So, I can write mass is equal to density into volume. So, here mass flow rate can be written as the density multiplied by the volume flow rate, and volume flow rate can be written as a product of area into velocity. So, here comes our equation, rho 1 a 1 v 1 equal to rho 2 a 2 v 2. Now comes the assumption. Yes, our assumption was flow should be a incompressible. Yes, incompressible means its density should not change. So, density should be constant. If rho 1 is equal to rho 2, I can write equation as a a 1 v 1 equal to a 2 v 2. Now, this is the continuity equation. Yes, so we can see here diagram. Now, flow rate, whatever the inlet should be at the outlet. Yes, here you can see here flow rate, it should be here and it should be here. Though there is a change in a cross section, flow rate should be a constant one. So what conclusion we can make from this thing? Yes, whenever there is a change in area, if the area is changing, if the area is reducing, then velocity should increase. Okay, and if the area is increasing, velocity should decrease. So this is the conclusion from the continuity equation. Now next thing is the Bernoulli's equation. Continuity equation, it was the law of conservation of a mass. Bernoulli's equation, it is a law of conservation of energy applied to the fluid flow. Let us check. Yes, what it says? It states that for a steady and incompressible fluid flow, total energy at any point should be a constant. So what are the various energy associated with the fluid? First one is the pressure energy, kinetic energy, potential energy. Sum of all these three energy should be constant at any point. Now, here pressure energy can be written as a in terms of a P, then kinetic energy rho v square divided by 2, and then the potential energy, it is a rho g z. Now what is the physical interpretation of same formula we are taking on the next page? Yes, what is the physical interpretation of these three things? Yes, first thing is the pressure energy. Now here for the measurement purpose, same energy we are writing in terms of a head. So instead of energy, here I have written pressure head, then here velocity head and potential head. These represent the energies. First one is the pressure energy. What is pressure energy? It is the energy associated with the fluid by virtue of its pressure force, that is called as the pressure energy. Second one, kinetic energy. It is the energy associated with the fluid by virtue of its motion. And last one, potential energy. Yes, similar manner we can define. It is the energy associated with the fluid by virtue of its position. Yes, so this is the third definition. Now here we can have a video visuals of this thing. Yes, how this continuity equation and this Bernoulli's theorem work. Okay, so here flow is there. Now here we can see fluid particles are flowing in a straight line. Now there is no friction between these two. Yes, whenever they intersect, then there is a friction. Now here we can see it is flowing in a straight line, streamline flow. Okay, first one was the ideal fluid, fluid should be ideal, then streamline, then density. For the density, it should not change. Now here you can see here velocity, how it is changing. Initially it is slow. Now you can see when there is a change in area, then there is a increase in a velocity. Okay, and similarly vice versa, it is also a true thing. Now this is the, now why to learn this thing? We need to apply somewhere. Now this one is the venturimeter, it is the application. Now here previous thing same repeated, but now here how we apply? Now this is the application. Now this is the venturimeter. Now there is a decrease in area, there is a change in velocity and area, we have seen. But if I apply manometer to this two junction, then I can measure the differential height, and this differential height can give us the discharge. So this is the application and use of this Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, now next thing, once again we will revise. Yes, now we have seen what is the Bernoulli's theorem. So how this is applied? Now here we need to pressure energy. Plus, now I will write in terms of short, kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to constant. Now how it is applied? How it is applied? Now aeroplane is there. Now to this aeroplane, here high velocity air is coming to the tip of the aeroplane or under the planes of the under the wings of this plane. So what happens when this high velocity, yes, coming to this plane, and now kinetic energy is getting converted into a pressure energy and the potential energy. Potential energy means height is increasing. So plane can take take off. Kinetic energy is converted into a pressure energy. This pressure energy is lifting the plane. Now this is the application of this thing. Now, next thing, how perfume spray? Yes, perfume spray. How perfume spray? Now if I take a perfume in hand, yes, we spray. So if I press the perfume knob, then what happens? We are applying the pressure energy. Yes. Now this energy is getting converted into a kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy, it is spraying. Yes, and potential energy, now it is lifting from somewhere, so it is a potential energy. So this is the second application. Now interesting example, how ball swings. Yes, now ball, baller throw the ball. So what happened? Now here somewhere high pressure is generated. Yes, now this pressure, now if there is higher pressure, the kinetic energy is going to be a minimum one. So ball is going to have a stagnation point. And if from that stagnation point, ball may go a leftward, ball may go a rightward. So this is the application and this is the principle. By picking up this seal, yes, baller pick this seal in hand. Okay, so it throws in a such a way that pressure is generated on the different side. So it may a leftward or a rightward swing. Yes, so this thing can be achieved by using this principle. So this is the principle applied to the swing of the ball. Okay, now. To the summarize, yes, what is continuity equation? Continuity equation, anybody? A1 V1 is equal to, so mass flow rate is constant. What is now second? Bernoulli's equation, yes, total energy is a constant. Okay, and application, number of flying of aeroplane, venturimeter. Okay, these are the application. Now you can do the one thing. Now these are the various useful links are there. Yes. So swim portal link is given, you can copy afterwards if it is not visible. Yes, you can copy it afterwards and you can go on this website and you can learn the more objective of this thing. And in the next lecture maybe we will solve some problem depending upon this thing. Okay, so this is the end of session. Thank you.